with another video. In this video, as the title says, I've been tagged in 10 tarantula questions. So this came about just actually earlier this week. I was added to a Facebook group that was strictly for people like myself and other people that do videos on tarantulas. So I think it was, I'm not sure who started it. I think it was Moss, and oh my gosh, I forget the other person, I apologize. As you guys know, I've been kind of out of this YouTube scene for about 7 or 8 months, and there's a lot of new people that have started making videos, which is awesome, and we've all kind of collaborated, ended up on this one Facebook page, and this came up about to do 10 questions about tarantulas, about my tarantulas, and there were two other people that did it before me, which was Eerie Arachnids, and also Tarantula Cat. So Tarantula Cat did hers first. She tagged Eerie Arachnids, and Eerie Arachnids tagged me. So anyways, kind of cool. Don't like being in front of the camera, but I'm going to do it anyways. You know, it's good to get in front of the camera. It gives people, or lets people see us, you know, other than just hear us behind the camera. So anyways, that being said, I'm just going to get to the 10 questions. The first question is, what got me into tarantulas? As most of you guys know, I love all animals. My collection over the years has been, you know, everything and anything. Parrots, you know, snakes, lizards, you know, furry critters, rabbits, everything and anything. I pretty much had, owned, raised, bred a lot of them as well. So, you know, when I seen I could own a tarantula, obviously I'm going to want to have it because it's an exotic, and also, you know, I just was fascinated by them like I am most other animals. So that's, you know, pretty much a given. If you're generally into a lot of different animals, you know, you're going to want a tarantula. At least I did anyways. So anyways, the second question is, what was my first tarantula? My first tarantula was a rose hair, and I think that was a lot of people's first tarantula because, you know, they imported them like crazy up until a couple of years ago, I guess. That was the go-to, you know, first tarantula. All the pet stores had them. And many years ago, there was no such thing as the internet where, you know, you can order something, or there was like, there was no variety, there was no people breeding them. So you pretty much got all the pet stores had, and most of them, all they had was rose hairs or grandma's little porteries. So that was my first tarantula. Okay, and the third question is, what is my favorite species? This is a hard one. As anybody with a larger collection, it's kind of hard to pick a favorite, but I'm going to go with the Somnophilus cambridgei, Trinidad Chevron. Reason being is I kind of have a soft spot for them. I have quite a few of them. I've actually bred them. And that's not the reason why. I just, you know, for an arboreal species, they are, you know, they're just, they're great. Like, you know, they're, as they get older, they're out a lot more. Like, they eat, like, they'll feed off my tongs. They're not skittish. You know, there's the Somnophilus armenia, which I have, and also the Somnophilus poulterus. They're great too, but I find they're a lot more skittish or more reclusive per se. I just find the cambridgeis are, you know, they're just kind of in your face, not aggressive or defensive, I should say. But I've just had a real, I've had a lot of fun raising them, feeding them, shooting videos of them. So that would be my favorite species. Question number four, what is my dream tarantula? This one was kind of easy for me for a lot of years. Even when I, you know, had a few tarantulas, not a whole lot, I was always wanting this one particular tarantula. I never ever seen them at shows, reptile shows. That's where I get most of my tarantulas. Never ever in a pet store. But I'd always see them online, pictures and this and that. So So that species is Pulchritheria metallica, huge sapphire ornamental. A lot of people think they're overrated. I don't think they are. I think they're absolutely stunning. They're quite reclusive, but that's okay. But just the sheer beauty of the Pulchritheria metallica is, in my eyes, they're just probably one of the most beautiful trenches, in my opinion. So that's my dream tarantula. Well, I own one, which is great, but for a lot of years I couldn't find them. Or if I did find them, there's a couple breeders, you know, here in Ontario, but, you know, for a half inch sling, they wanted like $250, $300. And even mine, when I got it about a year ago, it was, you know, just a half inch sling, and even then it was $100, and that's, you know, pretty reasonable for here in Canada. And question number five is, how many tarantulas do I own? Currently, as of today, I own 85 tarantulas. Okay, and the next part of this is going to be, well, it's question number six. It's time to introduce one of my teas to you guys. So we'll pause this and we'll do that now. All right, so this is Marilyn. This is my Brachypalma Bomi Mexican Fireleg. Just love this tarantula. As you guys can see, she is going into, or she's in premolt. Her abdomen is bald and darkening up. This is probably one of my favorite brachies. It's also Marilyn Moore's favorite brachy, the Bomi. And also Erie Arachnids had on his video that he was tagged in, he was talking about his, he wasn't sure it was male or female, and he wanted suggestions on names. So I didn't comment on his video as far as the name is concerned, but he wanted a unisex name, and I think Moore. So I got Marilyn, and then if he was to name his Moore, then we'd have Marilyn Moore. But anyways, I just thought I'd throw that in there. Anyways, guys, the next question or part of the video is I have to feed one of my teas. So let me get a different tarantula down and we'll see if it wants to feed. All right, this is Theraphosa apophysis, pinkfoot goliath, and she should be hungry. So she's sort of kind of facing the wrong way. She's under her water dish. Hopefully she's gonna turn around and feed. There we go. No fangs on that thing. My goodness. Let's see if I can turn this around. I'm on a bad angle. There she is. Beautiful tea. I got this one. Oh gosh, it's probably about an inch and a half. Had her probably about a year, I'm thinking, in around there. Great tea, likes to kick hares, and great feeders, as all Theraphosas are. Anyways, guys, I'm not going to leave it on her too long, because we got a few more things to do. Question number eight, what is my favorite YouTube channel? This is hard, guys. I have so much respect for so many people in the tarantula and reptile community, like Marilyn Moore, Tom Moran, Moss Tarantula, Moss Tarantulas, I think it's just Moss now, Erie Arachnids, West Coast Arachnids, there's so many, guys. Like, as most of you guys know, I not only do videos, but I subscribe to a lot of people. Pretty much anybody that's in the tarantula community, I'm a part of that, or was a part of that, going to be a part of that again because I've been away for a while. But I hate having to choose, because there's certain things I like about certain channels, like Tom Moran. Like, the guy is like the tarantula whisperer. Like, his rehouses, they're just amazing. Like, you know, and he's so knowledgeable as far as tarantulas go. I mean, I've learned so much from him, so much from other tarantula keepers. You know, Dark Den, amazing channel. I mean, the guy's subscribers have gone through the roof, and deservingly so. You know, but and if I forgot anybody, I'm sorry. There's just so many great channels out there. But I'm with Erie Arachnids on this. My favorite YouTuber is Trey Beck, Reptile Junkie. Him and April are amazing people. You know, they're just great. They're a great couple. You know, April for the most part is behind the camera. Trey's always in front of the camera, which is awesome because I hate being in front of the camera. Hands down, my favorite channel is Trey Beck, Reptile Junkie. A couple of different reasons. I just like I just said. But you know, I'm a huge reptile guy too. I used to be, due to certain reasons. I don't have the reptiles that I used to have, but I was a huge reptile guy even before I was into all these tarantulas. And Trey and April, their collection is just second to none. You know, the husbandry, the tanks, just the care they give their animals is awesome. So, you know, this was hard for me, guys. Like, and I don't like putting, you know, picking a favorite of anything because there's so many great people out there. But that's what it's going to have to be on this video. So, not on this video, but I have to say on this video. So, anyways, guys, great job. Keep up the work, or the great work, and it's been great knowing you guys. Like, you know, I think Trey was one of my first subscribers, and, you know, he supported my channel. I've obviously supported his channel, and, you know we chatted back and forth on his channel, on Facebook or whatever, and just great people, all in all great people. Question number 9, do I have any other reptiles or exotic pets? I do. I have a couple scorpions, I have a dog. Honestly, guys, I hate to say this, but I did have to downsize on my reptiles just because a lot of you guys know, you know, I was having some personal reasons and whatnot. I didn't really want to have to say it in this video, a lot of my snakes are gone, the big things. I'm not going to get into it, but I do have one snake left. I have a Pac-Man frog, I have a pixie frog, what else do I have? I don't even know. I'm looking around here. But pretty much for reptiles, oh, I have a leopard gecko. It's a rescue. Someone wasn't taking care of it properly. It's bouncing back. I still have my chameleon. I still have Scally, bearded dragon. But I think that's it for now. I'm just looking around trying to figure this out. But I'll do an update video on my reptiles and also maybe another tour of my tarantulas. I do have a tarantula room or animal room, whatever you want to call it. It's not up to where I want it to be before I actually put it on camera, but I'll do that at some point. Okay, so the last part of this video is I have to tag someone else. This is hard, not hard, but it's a hard decision for me because there's so many people that are involved in this. Everyone's going to get their chance because it's just going to go down the line, and there's a lot of new people joining the YouTube tarantula site, YouTube tarantula site, and it's just growing and growing more. So, but I'm going to tag Trey Beck, Reptile Junkie. Sorry, Trey, but you're up next. April's a big part of this as well. She's generally behind the camera, but I would like to see her answer some of these questions along with Trey, because she's, you know, initially earlier in their channel was starting out. Trey was even saying, like, the tarantulas are more April's, you know, that's her part of it, or that's what she likes. So I know Trey likes them as well, but I would like you guys both to be involved in this. So you guys are both tagged. So anyways, the next part is I have to ask them a question. And I'm not sure what that is, so I'm going to pause this for a second. So my question for Trey and April is, I want you guys both to answer this, is what is your favorite tarantula in your collection? Not your dream tarantula, because your dream tarantula could be something that you don't have, but I'd like to know what's your favorite tarantula. So that's it for all the questions that's in this tag. Now I have to answer the question that Erie Rapids tagged me in, or wants me to answer. And it was, I don't have it written down, but it was to do with what is my, not my least favorite tarantula in my collection, but if I could do it again, per se, what tarantula would I not purchase or add to my collection? This one is, again, hard, because I like all my tarantulas. Like, you know, we buy them because we like them. But I think the one species that I was a little disappointed in, and I'll explain why, was the Neophilinc, sorry, I might have butchered that, but the NNC, Trinidad olive. They're a dwarf species. I had six of them. Initially I started with five, then I got another one, I added it, I had them set up communal. All five of my communals ended up males. They all matured out, obviously they all passed on, and my sixth one that I got after, I got from a friend of mine, it matured out within 6 months, and it passed on as well. So it's not that I didn't like the species or anything, I just, not a bad experience, but I was a little let down by it, maybe it's because I ended up with all males. And to be honest with you, I'm not a huge fan of dwarf species. I do like smaller spiders, like I like the trapdoors and stuff like that, and jumping spiders are all great, but I'm just not a huge fan of the dwarf species. So that would be my question, or my answer, Dave. Hopefully it was good enough, but it's hard to pick. Like it's not that I don't like them. I didn't like them. I was just a little disappointed, and I guess it's because maybe I ended up with a whole bunch of males. So I believe this is it for this video, guys. Thanks for watching. I want to thank Erie Rapids for tagging me in this video. I will leave a link to Trey's channel in the description, and you guys can go and check him out from there. I think that's how we're doing this. If not, I'll have to figure out something else. But I seen Dave tag me in his description, and Tarantula Kate tagged him. So I think that's how we're doing. But anyways, if not, we'll figure it out. But hopefully this keeps going, guys. And, you know, if I didn't mention a lot of other channels that I am subscribed to. I apologize, there's just so many. And, you know, I get a little crazy in front of the camera and my mind just slips. So, anyways, guys, thanks for watching. You guys have a great day and great night wherever you're at. Take care. Bye-bye.